Hello friends, welcome to CNS Viewpoint. Just like every day, we are back again at 5 p.m. India time with our thoughts and perspectives, viewpoints on something which made us think today. And today we are going to talk about a news which we read in a Hindi newspaper that there is a big hospital which was constructed in Uttar Pradesh. It's a five-story building constructed in Uttar Pradesh, 200-bedded hospital, fully air-conditioned, with facilities for residential premises of for all healthcare workers, including doctors and hospital workers, and you know, fully equipped, etc. So, but there was one shortcoming, and that shortcoming is the important because it is preventing that hospital to start contributing towards public health or public service. And that shortcoming, friends, is that the recruitment of doctors and other hospital and healthcare workers has not been done. Can you imagine that? Just imagine a scenario: 200-bedded hospital, fully air-conditioned, five stories, with residential premises for hospital employees, and the recruitment has not been done. So can we talk about coordination? How many times have we heard about multi-sectoral coordination, multi-stakeholder coordination, integrated responses, bringing different sectors together for improving health security or health services or public health? But this is the ground reality, that we fail to ensure that not a single moment's delay should happen when a new hospital is built or in any other public service is made functional. And because this is, government is using public money to make these services possible, and just a little bit of more coordination and thought, that would have made a huge difference. Only if someone would have thought and ensured that when this infrastructure becomes functional, then we have in people to run it. We have doctors and other healthcare essential nurses, other paramedical staff, other ambulance drivers, other all kinds of different healthcare and hospital staff which you require to make a hospital fully functional and efficiently functional in public service. That should have been there. Can we afford this delay in maximizing public health outcome of this huge investment which has gone into the construction and purchases? We all know, as citizens of developing nations, that construction and purchases also gives a scope for of lot of corruption. And no wonder that margins, commissions, range of different kinds of things which should not have be happening, but they do happen, at least in the news if you read properly. So we need to ensure, friends, that only constructing big hospitals is not seen as development, because after all, this is a democracy, and in democracy, governments can be held to account, and we the people should not only view new hospitals as development, but also decline in preventable illnesses, also strengthening public services, health services across the board, and not just super specialty hospitals, but also to the ground level primary healthcare centers and services, but also preventive health, which must become mainstay when we talk of health for all, and when we talk of universal health coverage. With these thoughts, and let us hope that the recruitment of all hospital staff happens without any further delay, as soon as possible, so that the hospital become fully functional and dedicated to full capacity, full potential to public service. So with these thoughts, let me conclude today's CNS Viewpoint. Tomorrow again at 5 p.m. we will be back again with our views and thoughts about something that might interest us and make us think. So till then, bye bye, stay safe, stay healthy, take care, be happy, and see you tomorrow at 5 p.m. India time. Bye bye.